Round four.
It is a 2v2. We're down to the last round, and we'll see if this AI can beat us. Then it means you want to know, how is the game, and should I get it? So countless other people are probably putting up before you buy guides and such, but in my honest opinion, I wanted to do my own. So should you buy this game? In the current state, I would actually say no. Yeah! And the reason I would say no that this game does not play as smoothly and as nicely as I wanted. And I'm not talking about FPS. FPS is fine. I'm getting over 60 at any given moment on high settings with a GTX
770. You lost Zone A. You captured Zone C.
So FPS is not the problem. But the combat just seems a little worse than I was anticipating. And it seems like it's just a lot harder than I thought it would be to get it correct. I find that everyone who's playing currently already has a massive lead on me in skill. As you can see from here, I've gotten a kill, and really, that was from the mashing buttons. When you come up to a harder enemy, however, it can really be hard to do just about anything. Especially because they just know the game so much better than me that they can win. Oh my gosh, I'm really not doing a good job of showing, how bad I am compared to most. And honestly, that's a good thing. It seems that in this match, I was finally paired with people at skill levels near my own, so that I didn't have to worry about being constantly dead. I've found matches in which I literally had two bots on my team. It is a 4v4 game mode, and two of them were bots. Now, not only is this unacceptable in a competitive sense, it just really made me have to basically carry the entire team, and I couldn't do it because I wasn't good enough to be able to carry a team. So, especially with the next game, when it did put us with four people, there were two javelin halberd users, I don't know which weapon it was, and they could outrange you. If you tried to run away or even step backwards, they were always close enough to hit you no matter what. In terms of gameplay, this game is, when you get it right, extremely fun, and some of the things you should probably know going in is that captured sights allow you to heal your health back. It's also good to know that you want to be team playing, and you can even attack without being in the combat stance, and do team damage, so watch out on that. Blocking is done by putting your mouse, as you can see I'm moving my sword around, putting that in the same position as the enemy. If it's done correctly, it should parry the attack, and can be paired with a follow-up strike, although I don't have much experience with this. Wow, I'm gonna have to do a lot of audio editing for this one, so it sounds coherent. It's hard to play and talk, guys. It's pretty hard. I see why Frankie does most of his stuff post. The game looks great, though. I have to say, I was really excited for this game until I started playing it and getting destroyed. Honestly, I think this game could be easily fixed with more practice in the player's part, as well as having a balance system so that ranks aren't just all thrown together. I realize that this is a beta state, and that there probably weren't enough players to actually do this, but in the future I would definitely like to see ranks actually matter.
You lost Zone A.
Definitely the buttons can be a massive problem. I noticed that in the heat of a battle, it's very easy to accidentally hit control, come out of your guard stance, and you're completely defenseless to any direction of attacks that your character isn't automatically defending against. Honestly, most of the skills feel almost after the fact, and that might have just been my play, but I didn't even know there were skills until very late. Just wait for the timer. I honestly do think this could be a fantastic title, but whether it's just balancing or whether I'm just not a good enough player is really, I don't know yet. The bots in single player fights are harder than most players, but even when you fight players, you'll find that those people are vastly outranking you. So, to counter this fact, really the only gameplay mode you can play as a normal person is 4v4. Every other game mode will end up with you fighting in a 1v1 scenario against somebody who will probably, most likely, be either better or just more fluent in game mechanics. Again, another feature that wasn't actually pointed out to me in the beginning training sequence was that there are actually combos in this game. Buttons for all kinds of stuff. I came into this not knowing which player I was going to want to play, as the tutorial only shows you the Viking class. And after playing, I realized that many of the classes can easily dispatch certain types of enemies. This character, for example, has quite a bit of range on most. To go for a heavy attack when I got hit in the back. Getting hit in the back happens extremely often, and is not really a game-breaking feature. In fact, you can call for a revive so that your character or your friendlies know where you are on the battlefield. It draws attention to yourself so that you don't have to worry about not getting revived by that friendly who's passing by. And because of the competitive nature of the game, teamwork is actually a good feature. They've nailed that in my regard. They have created an environment in which it's very unlikely that you're going to pass a friendly on the ground and not pick him up just because you didn't feel like helping. You're going to be helping your teammates quite a lot throughout this game. And really, that's a fantastic game mechanic. It's done very well. Even with the team killing, provides an element of skill so that you don't accidentally roast your friends. But I feel like at a certain point, the game simply falls apart. It's too much for you to handle as a player, at least as a low rank player. And again, this is not my usual type of game. First person shooters are a lot of what I play. the examples that I have, other than hitting control and accidentally bringing myself out of combat, is that a player will start to mash on you.
You captured Zone A!
And really, you just have to block over and over. And you can see this guy was able to somehow catch up to me, even though I was running away, and we both have the same speed. So obviously something was put into play right there, in which he used, I'm guessing, some kind of combo to lunge forward.
You lost Zone A.
Again, this is not explained to the basic user, and so he wouldn't even know that that was an ability. And in fact, the ability I'm currently trying to use doesn't seem
you
to...
You captured Zone A!
Activate, which was supposedly space plus left mouse button, should have given me something known as the helm splitter. Unfortunately, that doesn't seem to activate, or I'm just doing it incorrectly. The game also has multiple interface modes, as you can see. As you might see, I am at the minimal speed, so this is how you can play if you set it to minimal. It does say it's for advanced players, but all in all, it doesn't actually take away anything that you need as a beginner. It just makes the game look a little more cinematic. At the end of every round, you get rewards, which are nice. Although, so far, I don't think I've reached a single... I've gotten anything that wasn't slightly terrible. I don't know what this means. This system is also not explained, other than that you know that it's a system much like Planetside 2, where all the teams are facing each other. Just to show off how this works, and how little... Okay, so... Unfortunately, in this game mode, it gets incredibly weird in the way that it presents the menus. You almost feel trapped inside the menus. You can't figure out exactly what's going on. And the money system is a little hard to find. In certain menus, it doesn't show your money when you're actually going to recruit people. So, for the sake of this, we're actually going to unlock a new character and see if I can do a little better with him. I am a fan of the character that I've been using just because I like his long reach, and the samurai class looks nice. And obviously in this kind of game, you want to go with a mixture of balance for what you like to play and what you like to look at, because you're obviously going to spend a lot of time looking at the character that you're going to be constantly leveling. You can see the level of the character, me being 1, and then next to it, I believe, this is the level of the person. It might be that after the game releases, they will add that matchmaking, and I really have to stretch that. Because without it, it just... you can fight enemies who can do massive amounts of damage to you, and you don't even get a chance to do anything. This is another problem. I am currently using an Ethernet cord with 100 megabit per second download and about 50 upload, and yet I keep getting problems with internet. Obviously, you can see this guy just left, so it had to reset and probably assign a bot. And you can see now we have started the game, even though certain players haven't even loaded in yet. It's very easy to get sandwiched, although that's a lack of my skill as a player. You can see me here struggling to try and fight 2 people. Now, it is a definite increase, as I've said before, teamwork is critical. And if you can maintain it, and especially if you have someone playing with you, although I have not been able to test it, I can assume that it would be quintessential in your victory. Because having the ability to talk to one person and constantly be with one other person gives you a massive advantage over all the other players. There is also the ability to climb up and down ladders, and you can even attack people while you're on those ladders. The problem being that somebody can camp on the ladder, and if you don't grab them correctly, they'll kick you off of it, and you can die from the fall damage. A little more work probably needs to be put into that system so that it's a little less cheaty to be able to come down on top of that ladder, because theoretically you can camp around a ladder every time somebody goes to actually come up the ladder, you get on at the top and then
you capture
your way down. You can see that I captured A and went back. I was going for a...
You lost zone.
Sometimes, I've talked about this before, in an almost random fashion, it seems like sometimes you just cannot get block breakers down. And now, you can see the character that I referred to before is incredibly good at stopping any kind of retreat. Simply because she outranges pretty much everyone here. The AR actually doing something in this part. As they are doing nitpicky damage to me, there is also a stamina bar in the game that allows you to become slowed and in a black and white state. And you can see that there's someone following us up the ladder.
You capture.
They decided to run off, probably because they realized the futility of it. But these spots do give you a nice overview of the map. So if you can maintain these parts, which allow you to regenerate, you can obviously do way better for your team. A pretty big strategy in this game, and one that will continue to be, is running away from a fight. However, sometimes it just seems that certain people are very good at stopping you from retreating, while others as you can see, that guy was able to continue to chain me while I attempt to fight one person. I easily could have dealt with him earlier, except the problem was that I wanted to finish my kill. It does seem like a lot that a teammate will come to help at the very last second and stop you from being able to finish a fight, which can be a very big hindrance as a player. But that is not a game flaw. Not everything that I refer to in this video is a game flaw. Much of what I'm talking about is just in-game stuff and what you need to be aware of when you want to buy this game. There's a lot to think of, whether it's should you attack the group of two because you think you have enough skill to take them both? Do you have the health required to take on one? Weighing what their skills are compared to yours? My character is an average fighter for the most part, although this one is, I believe, set more in speed. One of the big things that, or the big problems that I have, is that player teams are hard to distinguish. If you forget that you're orange, even for a second, you can become extremely confused in the battle. Oh, see how we spun a little farther away on this map. Oh, not really though. I mean, oh, I just spawned. That's not you. Okay, wait, which team are we? Oh, we are blue. Or orange. We're orange. I couldn't tell. See, that's one of the complaints that I said with the game, is I can't tell which team I'm on quick enough. Because, I mean, obviously it's in the color, but it's very hard to tell exactly which players are for which team while trying to fight someone and dodge and do everything else. So it's a ridiculous amount of multitasking that goes into playing this game at every given moment. Taking B is a role that is different to the other sites, which are simply stand on them. For this one, you have to fight the NPCs enough that your NPCs can progress to the other side. When this happens, you take over B. However, B does not have any regenerative properties, so taking this should be done after you have these on the other side. You can see here, I've actually probably screwed myself because they have captured C. However, another teammate just joined, so I should be able to take them. and recaptured the site for our team. The bars in the top right show the player team score
Zone C.
And which sites are controlled. When the bar fills, both teams or the if both bars fill in that scenario, which can happen, both teams will become in a one-life state. If you go down, you cannot be revived, and if you all die, the game is over. This also happens on each side, so if we reach it first, as we're about to, then we will, the enemy team will enter this last state, but we will not, so we'll still be able to revive. This is called breaking state, and when it's entered, the enemy team cannot revive themselves and will get killed if they die.
You lost Zone A.
One of the things that I like to nitpick is the fact that getting cornered is incredibly easy, and that happens for both teams, but
you captured
in
zone
breaking
A.
stage, it can be a very large hindrance, as you'll usually enter a 4v4 battle. When that happens, I like to take a second to leave, even though my teammates might be injured, so that I can go for a site and hope to secure more so that we can enter breaking state. I talked about how easy it is to hit control, but hitting alt to switch which player you're actually attacking can be a little hard to do when trying to dodge with the space key. All the buttons that you need to use in combat are pretty much along that bottom three row of your keyboard, and this can be incredibly difficult to manage all at the same time. And that's not even a multitasking issue as much as a control scheme issue. You are free to change this control scheme, but the default theme, although allowing easy access to every button, does seem a bit cramped. They do have a slider for the sensitivity of the control key, although I will test it as
you
I
lost
don't see
zone
how it really works. It changes the sensitivity and responsiveness, so theoretically it could be.
You captured Zone A!
So the nature of the sensitivity is how fast you actually come out of it, so that you can still come back in quick enough to not get hit. Your character will block, I believe, one side when he's
not
in
Zone A.
When Revenge State is active, especially when you're going in for an attack, it usually knocks you over, which gives the Revenge State player a very large chance to hit you. I'm trying to pack this in as much as possible. Now, Revenge State is still an unknown to me, as it seems like it's dealt by damage, but sometimes you can see someone go into multiple Revenge States in a single life in close proximity, as you saw right there. That Halberd user was able to call upon Revenge twice. I've reached my second level. This reward doesn't seem to want me to be able to use it. This reward will give you more revenge mode time, but will also make it so you are slower to regenerate your stamina. This character functions on the agile state, while this one is adaptable. The difference of these? Who knows? It does not tell you what these mean. Adaptable could potentially mean anything, and is not explained well enough to really help you. If there was more in-game documentation that I could easily pull up about things such as this, it might be. This definitely seems like the game that would be easy for someone who really wants to invest the time to get better, but is really not good for the casual player that is the market today. jumping into this game will definitely get you killed, as it has done me. You can usually equate first player skill with casual level, someone who's only going to play it once a week, or maybe not even that often, as is the case with many console players. Adults who don't have the time to play the game are not going to be able to compete with the players who play this, maybe even competitively, if we can see an E-League come out of this game. Although I think the game might need a little more variety and or balancing for E-League to really take off. Now, as I've said before, you can actually see the bots are spawned into the match to take over for players, but the players don't actually spawn in. So the game doesn't wait to start until you're all in, which means that you can potentially start into a match and have the enemy team come in before you. I don't know why this is the same place, or why they don't have a warm-up system so that once all players join, that you might be able to start the actual game. Said before, the team is not shown as well as you probably would like. They should probably do some kind of graphics change to either have friendly teammates have larger icons above their head, or even give them a glow when they're around you. More advanced tutorials, although they might exist, were not shown when playing. So maybe these should be included for future players so that you can really learn how the system works, because at the moment, it seems very smash. When the first person gets the hit in, it seems like it's incredibly hard for anyone else to start and counter.
You lost Zone A.
This is an example of when two people of the same class fight each other, and it's actually very interesting for me, as I've currently never done it, but it has shown me that there is a level of balance between two equal players. This person has obviously come here to regain health, but I wanted to get in the close and quick hits to kill them, because when an enemy steps onto the playing field, it will stop the healing effect as long as the site is contested. So using that, I was able to get in and try and kill it, although the attempt failed, and I was forced to run away as I was again trying to face multiple enemies. The game does have a very fun and very fast-paced feel when it's going well, but when it goes downhill, it seems like I am more prone to raging in this game than most others, and I don't rage like a normal person. I'm throwing controllers. I'm a more domicile rager, as it would have happenstance be. I'm outnumbered, so the best option is probably to retreat to your site. Now, keep in mind that all of these NPCs actually have rigid bodies, in that you can actually be stopped in their group and be killed while escaping. Again, that's a cool feature. That's not something I'm hating on the game for. Not all of this is negative, but I just don't know that the game is good enough to warrant $60. If you could get it for cheaper, I highly suggest this game, especially maybe closer to the $20 range, as it has the optimization and graphics of a AAA title, but just doesn't seem like something for the average person unless they're really invested. If you really like the way this game is designed, you will love it, and buying it is probably a must. But for the normal person who just sees this as another should I buy it at full price, I would hold off. And definitely wait, and maybe even try the beta if you could, and were able to get a code, so that you can figure out for yourself whether or not you like it. Environmental disasters are a pretty good one, and you can see right here, I just fell off. That kills you immediately and does not allow you to respawn, but again, we have managed to break them. Sometimes, even the best players in the game are stopped just because their team is not doing well enough holding capture points. You can have someone slaughtering all four players at once, but if those players manage to move to another zone while you're attacking, then you can easily still lose. So there is still that feel that even if you're good, you don't necessarily win. But in the breaking phase, and especially in a sudden death where both teams are in the breaking stage, it can be incredibly influential to have someone good on your team.
Sudden death.
Knowing when to alternate between right clicks and left clicks are still a little unknown to me, although I tend to go under the idea that if there are two people on a target and you're not being focused on, you should start doing right clicks. Make sure to try and keep yourself in the above attack position if you are near the player so that your swing doesn't damage the other person. A right click can do wonders if the enemy does not know you're coming, but left clicks can be helpful if you're coming to help a teammate. Thank you guys for watching. This has been a review. And hey, before you buy, for Honor. We'll see you in the next one.